back to another video, everyone. Today we are celebrating a new release from Simon Says Stamp called Beautiful Days. So let's jump in. The first thing I'm going to do is show you these new cardstock sleeves. Now Simon has been coming out with a lot of tools and storage supplies, and they're really great. This particular set of sleeves holds half sheets, and a lot of companies have half sheets. In fact, what you're looking at right now is a waffle flower paper pad, and these are, I think these were black watercolor sheets from Hero Arts that I got a few years ago. And of course Simon has a bunch of specialty cardstocks that they sell in half sheets. So these are really useful, these sleeves. Now, what I wanted to do was compare them to the storage envelopes that came out, I believe, last month. Now, the cardstock sleeves are just a tiny bit narrower than the storage envelopes. They're both the same height, but they are quite different. And I'm going to show you the difference here. So the sleeves, the new sleeves, they're very sturdy. Not that the other ones aren't, but these are just, they're very firm and sturdy, and you can see the size difference. And the storage envelopes obviously have a little flap that closes. The sleeves do not. So there are differences. The storage envelopes are really great for storing your large stamp sets, like the one I'm showing right here. So anyway, moving on, this stamp set, the Geoflower Building stamp set, I am obsessed with it. You're going to see a lot of this from me. And it actually has a matching die set, which I don't have yet, but I do plan on getting because it's going to open up a lot of other possibilities. But let's look at it with this new bold geometric stencil. These two can also work together. As you see here, there's a little stamp that you can combine for different options. And there's a couple other stamps that I'm going to pull out that you could also coordinate with this stencil. Like maybe you want a stencil in one color and then take the stamp and just highlight it in a different color. I don't know. The possibilities are endless. And honestly, when I saw this stamp set, my mind started racing and it was hard to kind of come up with one idea. So for today, I am just keeping it kind of simple. What I did was I came up with a pattern, and I did a practice pattern on a piece of copy paper, and that's what you see here. I folded it in half both ways so that I could find my center point, and then I lined up the center stamp. So obviously the center stamp was the most important, and then I built my pattern from there. So now that I have my test pattern on the copy paper, I can use it to line up my stamp for the good copy, for my final copy. I'm using Pink Fresh inks for the stamping today in this pretty yellow and pink color. I will have all ink colors listed on my blog, and you can find a link to my blog in the description below. So here we go with the first stamp. And I'm going to kind of breeze through the stamping because it ends up that a lot of the recording was the top of my head. And I know I don't want to look at the top of my head. I'm pretty sure that you all don't want to either. So what I am showing you here, though, is once you move on to the other stamps, you can kind of flip it over to get the mirror image, so you're not always having to place each and every stamp. Most of the time you just have to place it once and then you can flip the cardstock over. Now I did have to do a little bit of tweaking. And is the pattern perfect? No. I am neither a robot nor a computer, so it's not going to be perfect. Nobody's going to notice. And I love it. I think the pink and yellow is really fun, but I also think if you did it in turquoise and like a terracotta color, it would look like Spanish tile or something. So here I'm going to take the smallest black dot and I'm just going to fill in the center of those flowers with black pigment ink. And for my final card, you'll see in a moment here, I ended up putting an enamel dot over that black dot in the center of the flowers. You can still see the black center, but I did add those colored enamel dots. And I love this pattern and I love how the card turned out. I just added a very simple sentiment and I mounted the card panel on a cream card base, which I don't often do, but I kind of love. All right, so let's use the bold geometric stencil now. I'm going to use some pixie spray on the back of my stencil, and that's just going to hold it in place better. With delicate stencils like this, it's a good idea to use something like pixie spray. And again, I'm using pink fresh inks for my ink blending. And I'm just going to kind of place the colors in random spots. I'm not going to go from one side to the other. I'm just going to ink it up randomly. And I really love how this came out. I think these colors work so well together. And even where the pink touched the green, it didn't turn brown or do anything ugly. So I'm really happy with how it turned out. And, using the pixie spray just makes it so easy to ink up this stencil. I didn't have to worry about it shifting at all. So I completed this card off camera, and you'll see in a moment. I just used the mushroom stems dies from last month, which I am still so in love with. And again, added a very simple sentiment. And that card is done, and I love it. Isn't it pretty? All right, moving on to another product. So this is the Pastel Color Blend cardstock assortment. And it's already cut into A2 panels. And they have a glossy finish. So it's just a really fast way to make a card. You already have your background and you're good to go. Now, this is the second pack of these color blends that Simon has released. I'm opening up the original one right here, and you can see these are much more vibrant colors. But I love them both. I love how they added the pastel assortment. So we're going to use that one for our card today. And we're going to use the brand new Delicate Florals die. So what I'm going to do is an inlay die technique or a die cut inlay technique. And what I did was I ran it through my die cut machine once. Now this is a very delicate die, so you really need to either run it through your machine several times or use one of your metal shims maybe. But for the piece that I colored, I just ran it through once because I didn't want those pieces to come out yet. And you'll see how I'm gonna use them. But for now, I did glue one layer to my card, and you can see there's a little piece of the die that didn't quite get glued down, so I'm showing you a little trick. If you just put glue on a piece of paper and then just slide that piece of paper under the part of the die cut that's not adhered, then you can adhere it and you don't have to worry about bending it up to get the glue or anything like that. So I can't remember who I saw do that, but it's pretty genius. So here I am coming in with the color die cut, and I'm just kind of showing you how this is going to work. I'm going to put glue onto the card base and then poke these colored pieces into the glue to inlay them into that first layer. And then once we're done with that, we will add the second layer. So here, that's just me demonstrating all that. So now we're actually going to go ahead and glue these pieces in. And again, I'm going to breeze through some of this because, again, the top of my head is, not something we want to be looking at for 5 minutes. So here I am coming in, and I'm gonna take my craft pick and I'm just gonna poke those colored pieces into the glue. And what I did was I just did little sections at a time. I really didn't want to glue all of it and have to feel like I was rushing to get them all in because it does take a little bit of finessing. But it turns out to be really pretty. And I think these kinds of dyes just really lend themselves to this technique. So now we're gonna start kind of breezing through this. And by the way, I did color all of those pieces with my Olo markers, which I am still really loving. I still use my Copic markers from time to time. There are some colors that I'm just comfortable with, but every day they just get more dry, and I don't have all of the, I forget what you call them. I don't have enough extra ink to fill them all, and even when I do, I'm just bad about it. But I just feel like the Copics dry out. And it might be because I live in Colorado and, we live in a dry climate, so maybe that's why I have so many problems. But here I am coming in and I'm attaching my top layer. And look how pretty that looks already. So I really wanted to keep this card clean and simple. So I'm coming in with just a simple sentiment again. I think I mentioned in my last video that I often just do a very simple sentiment. For this Miss You die, I cut the top layer out of black glossy cardstock. And that's kind of one of my go-to things right now. I love glossy cardstock for die cuts like this. And once I adhere that, I think the only other thing I did to finish this card was add some glossy pearl embellishments. And that was it. So again, having this color blend background already ready to go, it just saves so much time and it's so pretty. And here I am coming in with my T-square ruler to make sure everything is straight. And there's the final card. I love this new die cut. The flowers are so pretty. All right, my last card uses this Sisters Forever stamp set. This is another fabulous set of sentiments from CZ Design, Kathy Zielski. And I'm holding it up so you can see some of the great sentiments. Best sister ever. Thanks, sis.
sisters from another mister. That's always a great sentiment. And then some of the little ones. There's a lot of little ones in here. Sisters Rock. You were always there for me. For my card today, we're going to use this one, the lucky to have a sister like you. So what I did was I pulled an alcohol ink background for my stash that I've been saving. And I just stamped the sentiment in the center of a square panel. And I used this inverted stitch scallop die to cut that circle frame out. And then I just added some gold pearls, and I really love how this card turned out. So here's a recap of my cards today. And you should definitely check out this new release from Simon, the Beautiful Days release. There are so many fabulous products. Thank you so much for joining me again today. I really appreciate it. And don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.